Yes, folks, the anti-vilification bill that is presently before the Victorian Upper House is nothing less than a speech silencing bill. And given that the state of Victoria is controlled by left-wing zealots, much the same as New Zealand is, we can be rest assured this bill will arrive on our shores before too long. And as you know, folks, I was recently silenced by YouTube for ridiculing the transgender movement, but it could get much worse for us under this new law. People who make disparaging remarks about transgenders could spend time behind bars. Have a look.
You're watching Outsiders. I'm Rita Panny, and I'm joined by the bold and beautiful Chris Smith and the always audacious Corey Bernardi. We're about to talk to a man who is working on the ground with some of the most persecuted Christians in the world. That's coming up next. But first, I want to let you know about a disturbing development in Victoria, a new assault against free speech that, if passed, could have grim consequences. Laws that extend the Racial and Religious Tolerance Act to include gender identity, disability, and sexual orientation are being considered in the Victorian Upper House. It's bad enough that illiberal bullies regularly launch coordinated attacks to harass, deplatform, and silence ideological opponents. Now they will seek more laws to punish them in the courts or the Victorian Civil and Administrative Tribunal for wrong speak. Under the pretext of tackling trolling and hate speech, the proposed laws will ban speech that is likely to incite hatred or likely to incite severe ridicule.
Yeah, those are pretty much the same as YouTube rules.
What utter lunacy. In the interests of accuracy, the bill should be called the Cry Bully Amendment. Instead of tackling trolling, the proposed laws pander to the worst type of online trolls, those who dish out endless bile but become indignant victims when called out. Cry bullies who use these type of laws to harass those who challenge their worldview. We've already seen women in the UK and Canada become victims of such legislation. Women who have been targeted by authorities for questioning the extent of the transgender agenda. As with Section 18C of the Federal Racial Discrimination Act, the process is the punishment. Innocent people who are accused are dragged through a stressful, costly, and time-consuming process that can be devastating. And this bill lowers the bar so far that anyone could be found guilty. If you do or say something that is likely to lead to severe ridicule, you could be going to jail for 6 months.
Yes, and that could easily happen to me. But it could also happen to people who comment on this channel as well.
On this program, every week, we discuss examples of the far left's weird and wacky ways. We don't employ the left's tactics in trying to get these people sacked or deplatformed or dragged through some tribunal. We simply mock the idiocy. Now they want to ban that. This bill will do nothing to make the internet safer or more civilised. Indeed, it panders to the haters and hypocrites who try to have their political foes sacked and silenced. Corey, this bill is before the Victorian Parliament. It's been referred. They're looking at it. It's a Labor majority committee that are looking at it. I tell you, I'm worried about this one because doing something that might likely lead to severe ridicule. I mean, is that where we are now with free speech in this country?
It's extraordinary. It's Orwellian, but it's the end of the Melbourne Comedy Festival. I mean, if you want to shut
down... Oh, no, they're all woke. Remember they got rid of the Barry Awards?
This is the problem. It only works one way. When you're ridiculing someone on the basis of their sexuality because they're white males or their sexual preference because they're heterosexual, that's okay. It's only...
Yes, exactly. It's okay for the left to attack conservatives, but not vice versa.
When it flows the other way. There is a devoid of common sense in Victoria.
But, you know, we've seen Jacinta Price cop the most disgusting threats and also just racial misogynistic abuse. None of these people who are so outraged by that sort of conduct speak up for her. It's always the usual suspects, the far left leaning folk who cannot tolerate anyone else's opinion.
And if you look at trolls on various platforms of social media, they are dominated by far left haters.
Yes, I see that as well. Now to some more problems with this bill.
Proposed laws will be used by cry bullies to silence those who reject leftist orthodoxy by banning speech that is likely to incite hatred, serious contempt, revulsion, and even severe ridicule. Yes, speech that may incite severe ridicule will be deemed unlawful under this legislation. Fiona Patten's Racial and Religious Tolerance Amendment Bill has been dubbed Section 18C on steroids. And it's easy to see why. If these laws are passed, the big winners will be lawyers and vexatious litigants. By expanding the vilification laws to cover a broader range of protected attributes, such as gender identity, it will see important debates and stories stifled. Contentious issues like giving children who identify as transgender hormone treatment or allowing biological males into female-only spaces such as bathrooms, shelters and prisons will be far more difficult to navigate, with those who oppose PC groupthink in danger of breaching the law.
Yes, to make them fear speaking out against their agenda. Yeah, so who is Fiona Patten? Well, she's the leader of the Reason Party, which used to be called the Australian Sex Party, which was formed by the porn industry. Have a look.
Now, what I want to do is go through some of your major points of difference. Wendy, I'll start with you. You mentioned G-rated outdoor advertising there. We've spoken to you on the show before about things like censorship of billboards. Why are governments better placed to decide what we should and shouldn't see than the general public and individuals?
It's a shame that it's got to be that way, Mel, but the problem is that our industry at the moment is self-regulated and it is not working. Our children are not being protected from highly sexualised images in our society. So we drive down the road with the children in the car and they are seeing things that we should not have to explain to them when they're 4, 5, 6 years old. I want outdoor advertising to be G-rated so that it's the same across the board. We have G-rating
Wendy,
for our children's TV
with,
programs.
How would you go with our billboard? Because I have a billboard that says the Australian Sex Party.
I don't have a problem with the Australian Sex Party at all.
You don't have a problem with the word sex, it's just...
No, I don't have a problem with the word sex, except when I have to explain it to a four-year-old child what it means. So I don't want longer-lasting sex plastered over a billboard.
But Australian Sex
and
Party
And I believe
is okay.
that the majority of Australians would not want that either. Yeah.
So, Fiona, to you then. I mean, some of the billboards are pretty graphic. You're OK with
Look,
all of them?
You know, I think some of them are fairly tasteless, but I don't think we need government intervention in that.
Yeah, she's such a hypocrite. She wants to have graphic, tasteless billboards, but she doesn't want us to have free speech.
So we need
have a very good system in place, and certainly, look, the Advertising Bureau has assesses itself, and I think we're finding that majority of people actually are quite happy with where it goes. And look, we do get tasteless stuff, but that's part of a free society.
That's part of a free society, and so is free speech.
Don't have to agree with everything that's out there.
Fiona is not actually speaking for the majority of Australians. She is speaking for the sex industry.
Yeah, and now this former sex worker is pushing the gay agenda. In other words, she's just another gay agenda activist. And that is the problem we have today. We have too many activists like her in government serving their own interests.